What's up, guys? This is DJ ESG, 30 years in the business, dropping knowledge on you. And today I'm talking about hiring a videographer with a brain. And what do I mean by that? Well, first off, before I even get into that, I'm a firm believer that you should have videography at your event. Everybody has a photographer. Not everybody has a videographer. There might be some moments that you can capture with some people that might not be here 5, 10, 15 years down the line that you might want to show your kids later in life. Like, this is a dance with dad. This is a dance with mom. This is a dance with grandma. This is a dance with grandpa. It's just nice to have to be able to show your future stuff later in life, or maybe come back to it once a year on the anniversary of somebody's death or the anniversary of somebody's birthday, just to kind of watch that. I know that my buddy Bob's wife watches every year the dance with her and her dad, and he watches the dance sometimes with his mom and some shots of his dad doing the toast at their wedding, because their parents have since passed away, all but one, and it's sort of their way of remembering them and being able to be a part of that, if only for a day. It's a really cool experience. I was there one time when they did it, and you could tell in their eyes and their faces that it meant something. But when I say videographer with a brain, I'm talking about three different things. First thing is, make sure they have the right cables. A lot of videographers want to plug into the DJ for clear sound. We are totally okay with that, but it is not our responsibility to bring the cables for them to do so. We don't want them plugging into our speakers. If they do that, there's a chance that something could go wrong with the speaker or something could pop. We want them to plug right into our soundboard. With that being said, they need to have one of three cords with them, or all three cords with them at all times. XLR cord, a quarter inch cord, and an RCA cord. At all times, with their little Zoom machine, they need to have that with them. Second thing is, when they are filming the ceremony or the first dance, do not walk in front of the photographer. Figure out a way to walk behind the photographer, because the photographer needs to be on the floor, on the ground, up top, on a chair, over to the side, taking this, taking that. Don't stand in front of the aisle. Don't block the shot. Don't get in somebody's way. Don't be in front of a toast. Be as unintrusive as humanly possible, but do everything the right way and get everything the right way. Be proper with it. Make sure that you get all the shots that you need, but don't impede the photographer. Now, why do I say the photographer, not the videographer? Well, the photographer is the person that needs to really have all the angles and jump around for the angles during the actual ceremony, especially, and during the dances, flying around in a circle. The videographer can get different shots from different angles, but usually the videographer is more on lines of recording an entire segment, where the photographer is more getting clips of different photos and different shots and different angles. A videographer can track a bride and a groom around an entire circle, where a photographer needs to wait till they get just to the right spot, just to the right lighting, just to the right section, before they snap that picture over. So make sure, as a videographer, you don't impede the photographer. And last but not least, do not put in your contract that in order for you guys to be booked on the event, you have to eat and drink. It is the most unprofessional thing to drink on an event. You don't need liquor at your event. You are there as a paid professional. You should not have liquor on your contract. Period. End of story. Food, absolutely. You should be fed. You should be taken care of. You should be able to get drinks and beverages, but not liquor. Stop putting liquor on your darn videography contracts. It is the most unprofessional thing ever, and it is really annoying to another vendor. You don't need a drink in that 5, 6, 7, 8 hours that you're there that day. Wait till you go home to have a drink. You're not there to party. You're there to capture a day. I'm ESG. I'll be back tomorrow. Take it or leave it. Peace, love, and God above, and I'm out. Bye-bye.